Joey Sims, Justin Sims, Joseph Morgan.
Reading their names one by one.
So it's the first time I've had that one set up.
Randy Abbott says he thinks of all the families left behind.
Wow.
The names are loved ones who died from an overdose in North Carolina.
Adam Creep, Amber Carter.
Randy's daughter,
Vanessa Abbott,
is listed near the bottom.
I was numb. I was everything that you can think of with grief, angry, numb, just you name it.
He says it took more than a year, but he turned that pain into action. Now an advocate for treatment and prevention resources, he says so many families think the opioid crisis won't affect them.
But I could point out probably a dozen names on this banner that the families will all tell you the same thing. We had no clue. We had no idea.
For the second year, Randy will travel to Raleigh along with dozens of families from the Triad. He says last year they announced that 150 people die daily from an overdose in the United States.
When we did the flyer for this year's event, we were at 175. Flyers were printed, and now before we even get to the event, we're at 198 a day.
Chase Hallman with GC Stop says overdoses in our area are still on the rise, and the drugs are getting stronger.
It's really impossible to tell what you're doing and how much of what you're doing is safe. So it's essentially poison.
Randy will carry the banner listing the names to the state capitol to be read aloud to the crowd, part of the promise he made during his daughter's eulogy to help other families heal.
You still mourn the loss and you still miss your loved one, but you're able to breathe again.
And Randy said,